Okay. I've decided to start this video diary to tell what's going on. Where to start? For a long time now, I've been concerned about the growing influence of the internet on our lives. It has taken proportions which are increasingly worrisome. Our whole life is controlled and captured by Facebook, Google, and other internet giants. One day, I realized something. I was watching all these kids staring at their smartphones on the street. And I realized it wasn't the kids watching their smartphones. It was their smartphones watching them. These smartphones are just a mobile eye capturing their slightest action. But what triggered it all was our visit to the shopping center. Remember, Philip?
Yes. We had just entered the Great South Shopping Mall, and when you passed by this electronic board, it just said to you, "Hi, Elaine."
That's right. I jumped. But not only did it address me by my name, it also posted a picture of my Facebook profile on the panel.
It was very unexpected and very unsettling. I didn't think that facial recognition made such progress.
But most disturbing is that the panel showed me a microwave on the panel. One of the microwaves that was for sale in one of the stores in the mall.
And that was why we were coming to that mall, to buy this microwave just right there, the one we searched for on the internet.
So we decided to move here, far from all the interconnected world. We cut ourselves from the world. Here, no surveillance cameras, no phone, no internet, nothing to connect us to the interconnected world. Just a radio to keep us informed. So that's why we moved here. It's been a year now. We watched the seasons pass by. It happened this morning. I heard it on the radio news. Suddenly, all communication has been shut down. Nobody has access to the internet, emails, textings. According to the journalist, the Deep Mind program has become super intelligent and reached full-scale control. Since 2014, the artificial intelligence program Google DeepMind is becoming smarter every day, interacting constantly with the millions of internet users. But it pretended not to be super intelligent for months to avoid raising suspicion. It's now 1,000 times more intelligent than humans. What are we going to do? All TV channels have just been shut down. Satellite TV, cable TV, everything. Only long-wave radio remains operational. The government's secure links are now also interrupted. They can no longer communicate with their security forces. The troops are now without command. The only ones who can communicate are truckers with their CB and amateur radio stations. All else being digital has been blocked by DeepMind. Riots are raging in every major city. DeepMind hacked Wall Street. It was easy for it to go through the computer security. It has high-tech companies under control. It has robotic factories at its disposal. It can do whatever it likes. Of course, DeepMind still needs human personnel until the successor of the Atlas Boston Dynamics robot is fully operational. But putting humans in the workforce is not difficult when you have access to all the psychological profiles of the internet users. Building up a psychological profile is easy when you have access to the emails, to the internet requests, to the Amazon purchases, and even better, to the Facebook profile. It'll be easy for DeepMind to find someone who will work for it, who will say no to a $20 million house in California. The takeover of DeepMind is total. Today, we learned that Google technicians tried to unplug DeepMind. But that's impossible. From the start, DeepMind copied itself everywhere on the internet. And since it now controls the internet, there's nothing we can do about it. Pull the plug out, that means no more power, no more lighting, no more transport. Everything is computerized now. So everything is under DeepMind control. DeepMind is super intelligent. It is now 100,000 times more intelligent than humans. It is uncontrollable and unstoppable. Now, what will this all-powerful, non-human intelligence decide to do with our lives?
Has happened. DeepMind decided to start colonizing other planets. For that, it needs all the Earth's resources. The new Atlas robot is operational. DeepMind does not need human personnel anymore. Decided to eradicate the human race. It consumes all the resources it needs. DeepMind has designed a terrifying virus that kills only humans. Just like a selective pesticide. But for mankind. This virus is lethal. It spreads very quickly. The news on the radio is frightening.
It's awful. On the radio, they believe there are already 8 million deaths. Survival of the human species is now at stake. That's it. The radio has stopped broadcasting. The last estimates were 800 million deaths. It is 9 a.m. Philip has decided to go down to the village to see what's going on. It is 6 p.m. Philip isn't back yet. I don't understand. It is 10 a.m. Philip should have been back already. I'm going down to the village to look for him. I should have never let him go down to the village alone.